Hey everybody, welcome to this midweek persevering word, man. I'm praying that the Lord is richly blessing you in a unique way, man. It's about studying, it's about applying God's word, it's about developing into the man and women that God wants us to be. And that's what this is all about, people of God. We have to grow daily. We have to make sure that we are being what God wants us to be. And that's representing Jesus Christ on a day-to-day basis, man. Let's get ready to go into the Word of God. I've been in the book of Joshua, chapter number 8, and I'm going to stay there. Even this week, we're going to be dealing with verses 3 and 4. Just all depends how it goes. But I know I'm going to start with verse number 3. If we can make our way to verse number 4, then we'll do that. I'm going to take my time with this thing. So I really want us to really get some nuggets and pull from God's Word and grow on a daily basis. And that's what it's all about. Praying that I can really reach to some young people today as well. So if you know some young people, share this, man. Let them know that Jesus Christ, He loves and He appreciates them and He is with them. And keep this in mind, that He used young people to do some powerful things. As a matter of fact, Joshua wasn't too old himself. So we're dealing with verse number 3, chapter number 8. And I'm going to read verse number 3. It says, "So Joshua and the whole army moved out to attack Ai. He chose 30,000 of his best fighting men and sent them out at night." The point that I pulled 2 points out of this verse. The point number one that I want to deal with is there comes a time when you must leave your comfort zone. There comes a time when you must leave your comfort zone. Because remember, he said, "Joshua, I need for you guys to move and attack." And you see, oftentimes that's what we have to do. We have to come out of our comfort zone if we're going to experience the true power of God. You see, you can't stay where you are right now and experience what God wants you to have. Remember that he told Joshua now that he says, "Man, you guys are going to possess Ai. You guys are going to take this thing over. You guys are going to knock the enemy out. But you can't stay where you are if you're going to do it." And you see, we want many miracles and we want God to do something for us. And we're expecting some big things from God. But we want to stay right where we are. You know how it is that we want to deal with the same folk in the same company. And we don't want to move from point A to point B. But you have to move. He said, "Joshua, you know," he said, "now y'all have to move. If you're going to do what I said, if you're going to experience what I'm telling you, then you have to move." And see, if someone out there, you have to move. You have to come out of your place of comfort. You have to come out of this thing. God wants to do some miraculous things. God wants to transform your atmosphere. He wants to transform your place, and you have to move. Oh, I know some people may not like that. I know some loved ones may not agree with it, but it's not about them. It's about you growing. It's about you having what God wants you to have. And so you have to move. Come out of your comfort zone. Come out of that place that you have been so used to being and move. Move and be ready to attack. You see, sometimes we have to attack the enemy and stop letting him attack us. We have to go after him and we have to let him know that you are and we are children of the Most High. I have a greater that lives on the inside of me and I'm willing to show it. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ and I'm willing to show it. Come out of your comfort zone. Young lady, come out of your comfort zone. Young man, come out of it and do as the word says. Remember, I'm reading verse number 3 again. He says, "So Joshua and the whole army moved out to attack Ai." They moved out to attack. He says, "And he chose 30,000 of his best fighting men and sent them out by night." God has chosen you to move. God has chosen you to move from one place to another. God wants you to move to experience the goodness. God wants you to move to experience that greatness. Point number 2 that I pull from that, God chooses those who are willing to fight. Come on, people of God, you have to be willing to fight. We're in a spiritual battle. Look at the news. We are in a spiritual battle. Go on the internet. We are on a spiritual battle. But God chooses those that are willing to fight. Man, you have to be willing to fight for your life. You have to be willing to fight for your place. You have to be willing to fight for Jesus Christ. You have to be willing. The Bible says, you know, that the Bible also lets us know that Paul says, I fought a good fight. Man, you have to be willing to fight. This thing is not supposed to be easy because the devil walks to and fro seeking whom he may devour. The devil wants to steal, kill, and destroy you, and you have to be willing to fight. God chooses those that are willing to fight. Are you willing to fight? Because there is someone that wants to take away that promise. There's someone wants to take away your blessing. There's someone that enemy wants to take that stuff away. And you have to be willing to fight. Attack him. Use the word on him. Use the word of God. Use it. Because he trembles at God's word. Man, I wish I can follow on with this thing. I don't want to be too long. You know what? We'll pick up on verse number 4 next week. We'll pick it up on verse number 4 next week. Just remember that God chooses those that are willing to fight. Remember that God wants you to come out of your comfort zone. Be willing to come out of your comfort zone. As he told Joshua, now, move. Move from that place, young lady. Move from that place, young man. Get tired. You see, somebody's out there need to get tired of being sick and tired of dealing with the stuff that you've been dealing with. Move. Be willing to move and attack, man. Be willing to move and attack what's yours. The promise is there. The blessings are on the way. Be willing to move. God shows you for such a time as this. It doesn't matter what you have done. What doesn't matter what you did. God has chosen you because he know you are willing to fight. I'm going to talk to you soon, man. I'm praying for you and pray for me. And we're going to continue to persevere through this thing together. God is good, people of God. I'm telling you, he's great. He's awesome. Even in the midst of all this confusion, he's awesome. So hang in there and be willing to persevere, because great things happen when you do. Remember, man, the church, the ministry is coming. I'm telling y'all, it's coming. It is coming. It is coming. So be praying for me, because I'm praying for you. And I'll let you soon. Peace out.